Okay, now one thing I think is important to explain is that, well, so far we've been using different scenes for keys and doors, right? But what if you want to leave the keys in the same scene as the doors? How would you do that? Okay, you can add the key normally, but let's see what happens when we try to rename it to door 2. As there is already a node named door 2 in the same hierarchy, and we can have two nodes with the same name, it is renamed door 3. So to solve this problem, we can create a new node and then make our door 4 a child node of this node we created. Doing this will all work in exactly the same way. Okay, now let's create a scene so that the key icon appears in this corner when we get the key. Let's create a new scene and add a canvas layer. Let's call it key canvas. Now let's add the keys. And let's rename them to door 2 and 4. We can save. And that's how they will appear on the screen. Okay, let's add a script. And let's create the show key function. So if the name door 2 is in the key folded variable and it's not in open doors, that is, the player has taken the key but has not yet opened the door, then the key corresponding to door 2 should be shown. Okay, so now let's create the hides key function. If the door name is in the open doors variable, then the key should disappear from the screen. And finally, let's create the delete canvas function, which will check if door 2 and 4 are inside the open doors variable, and if both are there, it will close the key canvas scene since there are no more keys to show. Okay, now we just need to call all these functions in the where function. Now let's open levels. Let's create the canvas variable that will load the key canvas scene. And let's create the key collect function. Where if the key founded variable is other than empty, if there is no node called key canvas, then it should be instantiated. Otherwise, that is, the key canvas node already exists, this node must be execute the show key function. Now here in where function, we need to call the key collect function. Okay, now we can go back to the key script and let's declare that when the player gets the key, the parent node executes the key collect function. Let's test our game. And it looks like the code is working, but we have some bugs. I probably forgot to change the visibility of the keys. Yeah, that was it. We have to make the two keys invisible here. Let's test again. And okay, now everything is all right. Okay, now let's go back to the example where both the key and the doors are in the same scene. Let's add the key the same way we did before. And so now what I'm going to explain is maybe a little complex, but you will learn a new one command that can be quite useful. So please pay attention. And God bless my English now, cause this is gonna be hard. Okay, the key code is trying to call the key collect function using getParent command, right? The problem is that this function is in the central node and not in the isort node. So we would have to use the getParent command, right? That way the key would call the command on the parent node of its parent node, and everything would work fine. But let's go back to level 1. Here, for to call the key collect function, it cannot use getParent twice. So I'm going to show you two solutions for this problem. If the parent node has the key collect method, so we want it to execute the key collect function. And of course, if the parent node doesn't have this method, then nothing will be done. Okay, so our parent node doesn't have the key collect method. So let's do the same check on the parent node of the parent node. Okay, let's test. Everything is working fine. Now we go to the second alternative, which is much simpler. As you know, our key is inside another node in the central scene. So all you have to do is always keep the same structure at all levels. That is, for the key that's on level 1, you just need to add a new node and put the key inside it. And just keep the getParent command. Okay, how I'm going to leave the keys in different scenes? So I will keep everything the same as it was before, and let's continue our tutorial. Now we just need to open the door script. And we need to have the hide kick function run when the door is opened. Let's use the getParent command to access the parent node. And then the central node will take the KeyCanvas child node and will make it execute the hideKey function. Let's test. Okay, everything is working perfectly. Now we just need to create that system that will show the doors on the map. Come on, we are almost done. Let's open the minimap scene. And then let's hide the central node hide. Let's add a color hex. Let's rename the door 2. Let's adjust the size and choose blue color. So we can duplicate, rename to door 4, position in the right place and change the color to red. Now we can open the script and create the showDoors function. And in this part, we will work with colors using the RGB format. Let's declare that. If door 2 is not in key found, then the color of door 2 will be red, 1, 0, 0. That is, the red channel will be at the maximum and the green and blue channels will be at 0. Okay, if door 2 is in key folded, then the color will be blue. And finally, if door 2 is in opened doors, then the color will be green. And of course, let's repeat the same thing for door 4. And then in the ready function, let's add the showDoors function. So let's make the hide node visible again. And as you can see, the two doors are appearing from above. So we need to place both nodes above the hide node. And now we can run our game again. And okay, everything is working exactly as it should. Okay, guys, I hope this video can help you. Since the last video, I've added German to my Duolingo, so see dich später.